So, good morning, good afternoon, all of you. I hope I'm audible and visible. Please give me a thumbs up if my audio video is clear to all of you. Okay, so I hope you all are aware that we are now conducting a plus course on an academy, which is very important, and the NEET PG pattern have completely changed. So I've decided ki I will put all the new questions here on the YouTube channel, as well as I will keep them on my plus course. So requesting everyone to please join me on my plus course. Now, about myself, I'm Dr. Cheshta Agarwal, your NEET PG educator on an academy, and I've myself scored All India Rank 261. So I will give you the tips and tricks which is required for you all to crack your exams. Now, before going ahead, why an academy? Because this is the best online platform for the preparation of NEET PG. It give you live interactive classes. It give you live interactive classes, which means that you can directly ask the questions during a live class to your educator. The next is, once you download the Unacademy learning app, you can access to all the free stuff on Unacademy, like special classes, like quizzes, test series, and Unacademy scholarship tests or combat. Now, all these three things are present absolutely free, and you just need to unlock them using a code that is CHESHTA10. We do have many batch courses also, but these all comes under the paid subscription. Now, the batch which I want all of you to join is the system-wise clinical rapid revision batch course, which is the best batch course for the preparation of NEET PG 2021. For FMG students, I would request the batch of Focus FMG batch. For next pattern, you have two courses going on, and for INICT, you have operational batch. So whatever suits you, I request everyone to please join. We have many free test series going on at 8 p.m. for NEET PG, 8:30 for FMG, 9 p.m. for next pattern, 9:30 for INICT, and grand test and scholarship test. All of them are absolutely free, so I request everybody to please join these test series. Now, we have two type of subscriptions, plus which gives you access to the live classes, quizzes, batch courses, and structured schedules on an academy, while Iconic will give you an additional benefit of prep letter, video lectures, question banks, rapid revision courses, or handwritten notes. So everything is given on the Iconic subscription. For Iconic, you can have a 1 year, 1.5 year, 2 years, and 3 years. 1 year is 55,000 rupees. Using the code CHESHTA10 will give you additional discount. And plus, we'll have an option of 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months, and so on. And if you use the code again on plus, that is CHESHTA10, you'll get additional discount on the subscription fees. So that is all for the today's session. Starting with the first question, please answer the first question, all of you. Please answer the first question. Please answer the first question. Pemphigus vulgaris, bullous pemphigoid, staphylococcal scarlet skin syndrome, or toxic shock syndrome. Now, for solving this question, please remember, whenever you have oral erosion and presence of flaccid bulla, these two combination, flaccid bulla plus oral erosion, it gives you a clue that you are dealing with a case of pemphigus vulgaris. Very important, if you get this combination, the answer becomes pemphigus vulgaris. The next question is, 50-year-old male, known case of myasthenia gravis, started with a shallow erosion, the oral mucosa is not involved, and immunopathology demonstrate IgG depositions on the keratinocytes and antibody against desmoglein 1. What is the diagnosis? Very nice, Jitendra and Adnana. Very nice, each and every one of you. So here remember that a patient tells you, the question tells you that IgG is against desmoglein 1, and instead of developing flaccid bulle, you are developing shallow erosion with scales. Please remember, scaly crust plus no oral erosion and antibody against desmoglein 1. It means that we are dealing with a case of pemphigus foliaceus. So the correct answer becomes option number 3, that is pemphigus foliaceus. Very nice, Jitendra, you are absolutely right for this question. Extension of a blister to the adjacent unblistered skin when pressure is put on the top of the bulla. What is this called as? What is this called as? Very nice. Very nice, all of you. So please remember, in the patient of vesiculobullous disorder, there are two bedside investigations. Now, if you apply the pressure from side, that is lateral pressure, then this becomes a classical case of bulla spread sign. But if you apply the pressure from the top, this becomes Esbo Hansen sign. Understood. So the extension of the blisters to the adjacent unblistered skin when the pressure is applied over the top of the bulla, then this is called as the Esbo Hansen sign. But when it is applied from the side, it is called as the bulla spread sign. Very important and nice. You all have written it correctly. The next question. Identify the skin condition shown in the image. Identify the skin condition shown in the image. Very nice. So identify the skin condition shown in the image. The correct answer is psoriasis. Whenever you see well-defined erythematous to salmon color, well-defined erythematous to salmon colored plaque or papule with superimposed silvery or micaceous scales, it becomes the correct answer of psoriasis. Very nice. Very nice, all of you. The correct answer is option number 2. Can you answer the next question? Very nice, each and every one of you. Very well done, everyone. Very nice. So an 11-year-old girl present with a 4-day history of red, scaly, widely spread rash in a raindrop pattern over the trunk. She is otherwise well till now, other than a recent severe streptococcal sore throat. What is the diagnosis? The correct answer is guttate psoriasis. Now please remember, whenever a patient develops a streptococcal sore throat from group A beta hemolytic streptococcus and subsequently develops raindrop lesions, it is a classical case of guttate psoriasis. Very well done, all of you. The correct answer is option number 2. Can you answer the next question given on the computer screen? Very nice. So what is the question says? That it is an old sportsman. Sportsman means frequent long sun exposures. He developed a nodulo ulcerative lesion. It becomes a classical case of basal cell carcinoma. Okay, so when a patient develops nodular ulcerative lesions over the face and there is a history of prolonged frequent sun exposures, it becomes a case of basal cell carcinoma. Very nice, Jitendra, Gaurav and Adrana. Very nice. Which of the following is the commonest association of paraneoplastic pemphigus? Which of the following is the commonest association of paraneoplastic pemphigus? Chronic lymphocytic leukemia, thymoma, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma or Castleman's disease. Please remember, the correct answer is NHL. What is paraneoplastic pemphigus? It is a pemphigus which occurs in association with underlying occult or clinical malignancy. And the most frequent association is non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Please remember, along with anti-desmoglein antibodies, you do see antibodies against the plakin group of family. You will see antibodies against the plakin group of family. Very, very important for all of you to understand. Okay. Next question. A 3-year-old child has itchy eczematous dermatitis on the flexure. The mother has a history of bronchial asthma. Diagnosis should be. What will be the diagnosis in this particular question? Very nice, very nice. Yes, so the correct answer of this question is atopic dermatitis. Please remember, atopic dermatitis, the diagnosis is pure clinical diagnosis. You have pure clinical diagnosis. You have Rajka's and Hanafin's criteria for making the diagnosis. So you should have 2 major criteria which should be fulfilled. And here they have given you presence of itching, dermatitis classical of atopic patients and history of bronchial asthma. All these 3 are the major criteria. So we are having more than 2 major criteria getting fulfilled. So the correct answer becomes atopic dermatitis. Please remember you have many minor criteria also. For example, you have presence of ichthyosis, Denny Morgan fold, increased risk of recurrent infections, increase in IgE levels, white dermographism, etc. So there are many more minor criteria which are present for atopic dermatitis. But in this question, we are having three major criteria and hence you don't need any minor criteria. The next question is given on the computer. A 4-year-old child with a high fever developed toxic look, eruptions on the trunk, proximal extremity, bilateral bulbar conjunctivitis without discharge. She also had desquamation in the perineum and fingertip with cervical adenopathy. What is the diagnosis? Very nice. Very nice. So can you see here what is given? They are telling you that a patient is having fever with involvement of the mucosa, involvement of the skin and lymph node. So this is an example of mucocutaneous lymph node lymphadenopathy syndrome. Mucocutaneous lymphadenopathy syndrome, and the classical answer is that of Kawasaki syndrome. The correct answer is option number 3. Very nice, Gaurav and Venkatesan. Please answer the next question. Very nice. I have told you a few days back only, whenever you develop blisters over the sun exposed areas, which is associated with scarring, it becomes nothing other than porphyria. So photodermatitis associated with blisters, which is healing with scarring, this is a classical case of porphyria cutanea tarda. Very well done, all of you. Can you answer this question? Can you answer the question? A 27-year-old male had burning micturition, urethral discharge. After 4 weeks, he developed joint pain involving both the knees and ankle, redness of the eyes and skin lesion. What is the most probable diagnosis? Very nice. So a 27-year-old male had burning micturition and urethral discharge. After 4 weeks, he develops joint pain involving both the knees. So what is this? This is a classical triad of Ritter syndrome. What does Ritter syndrome includes? Conjunctivitis, urethritis, and arthritis. Please remember, conjunctivitis, urethritis and arthritis is the classical triad of Ritter syndrome. Very, very important for everyone. Okay? Chalo, very well done. I think this question is clear. And along with that, what is this skin lesions? This is keratoderma blenorrhagica. This is keratoderma blenorrhagica, and another is Sarcinate balanitis. Keratoderma blenorrhagica and sarcinate balanitis is seen over the genital areas. So not here, it is seen over the genital areas. Very well done, all of you. Let's move to the next question. Anyone? Jitendra, Gaurav, Venkatesan, Adnana, a 40-year female developed persistent oral ulcers followed by multiple flaccid bullae on the trunk, extremities, direct examination showed intercellular IgG deposits in the epidermis. Very nice, all of you, very nice. So please remember again the same thing, whenever you see oral ulcer and you have intercellular cleft, it becomes a case of pemphigus vulgaris. Intercellular cleft means intraepidermal and oral ulcers, nothing else other than pemphigus. You have another clue, I've told you, flaccid bulla, wherever it is written, it becomes a case of intraepidermal. Can you answer the next question? A patient with psoriasis was started on systemic steroids. After stopping the treatment, patient develops universally red scaly skin with plaque losing their margins all over his body. What is the most likely cause in this patient? So patient with psoriasis was started on systemic steroids and he developed universally red scaly skin with plaques losing their margins all over the body. Classical case of erythrodermic psoriasis. Please remember, steroid induced psoriasis can cause either erythrodermic form or pustular form. But looking at the clinical picture, it is clear that it is not pustular, it is erythrodermic form. So the correct answer becomes option number 4. Jitendra, please remember, it cannot be drug-induced reaction because on starting the systemic steroid, nothing had happened. On stopping the drug, the disease have developed. In drug-induced reaction, on stopping the drug, you will have improvement. So that is a contradictory statement. Please remember that point, very important. Another question. Can you answer this question? Patient developed bulla without erythema on elbow, knee, sacral areas, followed by crust formation scarring in milia. No photosensitivity and negative family history on a DIF IgG deposits at dermoepidermal junction with no blood vessels is seen. Very nice. So please remember, yesterday only I have told you, this is a classical case of mechanobullous disorder which presents with scarring. But if DIF is positive, it cannot be EB dystrophic. It becomes a case of EB acquisita, which have IgG against the collagen 7. Please remember, it have IgG against the collagen 7. Palak, please remember, in EB dystrophica, you don't have any antibodies against the collagen. Okay, you don't have any antibodies against the collagen. That is a very important point. But in EB acquisita, you will see the collagens, you will see the presence of antibodies against the collagen. And that is why the answer becomes option number 2. Next question. Very nice, very nice. So after hepatitis B vaccination, the child with allergic family history and pruritus involving the face and convexities develop numerous umbilicated vesicles, which becomes pustular and hemorrhagic. So what happens? Because of the immunosuppression which occurs secondary to vaccination, the localized herpes simplex got disseminated and it presented to us with eczema herpeticum, also called as Kaposi varioliform eruption. Kaposi varioliform eruption, very very important for each and every one of you to remember. The localized herpes simplex becomes generalized or disseminated because of the immunosuppression in a patient with a background of atopic dermatitis. You all know that atopic dermatitis have Barrett effect. So now instead of localized lesions, because of the Barrett effect all over the body, they will develop the lesions or the other parts as well. 10-year-old boy presented with 10-year-old boy presented with painful bogey swelling of scalp, easily pluckable hair, lymph node enlarged in the occipital region. Which one of the following would be the most helpful for diagnostic evaluation? Very nice, Jitendra, Palak. Very well done. So here this is a case, whenever you see presence of painful boggy swelling, easily pluckable hair, this is a classical case of Tinea capitis. And for Tinea capitis, you have to do KOH mount. This question we have discussed yesterday only. Another question is given on the computer screen. 22-year-old female with greasy hyperkeratotic papules at the neck, chest, nail changes are present, which reveals acantholysis. In the presence of dyskeratotic cells, what is the diagnosis? Very nice, Neeti. Very nice, Venkatesan, Jitendra, Palak, everyone. Whenever you see presence of follicular and non-follicular keratosis, follicular or non-follicular keratosis, in a patient with associated nail findings, mucosal features and histopathology showing suprabasal acantholysis and dyskeratotic cell, it becomes a case of Darius disease. What is the gene defect? It is ATP2A2 gene which is defective in these individuals. Can you answer the next question? Please answer the next question given on the computer screen. Seven-year-old boy with complaints of asymptomatic hypopigmented macules over the forehead for 2 years, which were gradually increasing in number and spread to the neck and the forearm. Systemic examination was unremarkable and the biopsy shows vacuolated cell in the upper Malpighian and granular layer. What is the diagnosis? Pityriasis versicolor, epidermodysplasia verusiformis, vitiligo or progressive macular hypomelanosis. Very well done. Please remember the correct answer of this question is epidermodysplasia verusiformis. Jitendra, in pityriasis versicolor, why will you see vacuolated cell? What is pityriasis versicolor? It is a yeast infection, fungal infection. You will see on histopathology or on KOH mount, you will see the fungal hyphae and spores. But vacuolated cell is seen only in the patient of human papilloma viral infection. And the diagnosis is epidermodysplasia verusiformis. Very important. Epidermodysplasia verusiformis is the correct answer of this question. Understood? Nobody has given me the answer. Please give me a thumbs up if you understood. Vacuolated cells or ballooning degeneration is a feature of viral infection. And the only example for the viral infection-induced disease is option number 2 here. So I hope this question is clear, and with this I am winding up the today's session. I hope you have enjoyed this. We are done with the half an hour of the today's session. Please give me a thumbs up if you have liked my today's session. Subscribe to the YouTube channel. And please remember that I am conducting a plus course, which is the last plus course before your NEET PG entrance examination. So that is why I am requesting everyone to please use the code CHESHTA10 to get the subscription for Unacademy at least for a month. So bye bye all of you. Take care and we'll meet again tomorrow.